Hi guys, my name is Annie. Welcome back to my madness. I know it has been a long time since I posted anything. Life has been life. So as you can see, I've gone through a different hair color again. This was the crazy color. What was it called? Toxic UV in green, lime green, I think. And as you can see, it's sitting well. It's, pretty well faded. It's faded pretty good. It's clinging to my freshly bleached sections where I had bleached to get it blonde enough for me to put this color in. And so, yeah, I will be having to do something about a new color here soon. But I don't even want to think about that right now. I really don't. I got out of the shower not that long ago. As you can tell, my hair is still wet. I just washed my face and had the Ulla Hendrickson Fat Glow Mask on. So my face is not as dry as it could be after getting out of the shower. So I'm just gonna go through skincare and just kind of catch everyone up on what's all going on. I'm not gonna really get all gussied up because I'm not going anywhere this afternoon. So since I washed my face, I'm going to use two different toners I've found has actually been working really well for me. This is the it's this one. Is the aloe and tea tree toner. I like using this right after I wash my face to actually put on a cotton round or whatever you have and actually rub into my face. I'll explain why here in a sec. Just because I like it. I just like it. This is my skincare routine. Do what you like. Again, whatever I like, if you don't like or if you don't use, huzzah, just as long as you're happy, I don't care. So, my last video I posted was last summer, and that's because I gotta put some chapstick on. Where's chapstick? There it is. COVID hit, homeschool hit. Getting the kids set up for school and everything at the dealership where we were was interesting. It was hectic trying to figure out what to do for the kids, what to do with the business. And then last August, I started working as a dental assistant again for my old boss. He called and said, "Hey, Annie, I need help." And I said, "Yes, sir, you're the only one I'll go back with," because he was an awesome boss and I love doing it. I'm going to use another toner. This is a hydrating toner from Murad. And I use this as well as my Hangover Good in Bed Hydrating Serum with hyaluronic acid. With hyaluronic acid, you actually have to have something moisture, water-ish for it to work well. So I spritz myself with this toner and then I use this after it to kind of, make it work. So, I love the sprayer on that. It's not too intense like the Wet n Wild one I had a little while ago. Anyway, so last August I started, no, yeah, end of July, I started working as a dental assistant one day a week, only one day a week. And I love doing that in particular. So, yeah, and then we were supposed to move the dealership home in September. That didn't happen. We ended up staying where we were until winter was over, is what we told the landlord. And homeschooling and being at the dealership was, oh God, I hated it. I absolutely hated it. So trying to run the business with COVID, getting no help that we were supposed to be getting from the government, because there's a lot of, that's a whole nother video. This is a mix of the Ulla Hendrickson Banana Bright Eye Cream, as well as what was left of a Dr. Bryant No More Lines eye cream. So we were doing that, and I just did not have the time or the patience to really, you know, put up another video. I tried to find time, but with homeschooling and the dealership, it just didn't work. And so I stopped trying. And then we moved home finally this beginning of the month. And the dealership is home. We are no longer renting a place. We're actually building a shop out here. I hope to dear whoever above that, you know, the prices of lumber come down, because what would have cost us $7,000 last year to build is costing us $16,000 this year to build. So it hurts my heart, but it is what it is. So I did the eye cream, and that lets the serum sit in a little bit. And if I'm feeling fancy, which sometimes I am, sometimes I'm not, I will use an oil on my face. I've actually just got back into using oils because I have a dry spot up here that just would not go away until I started using oils. So this is Earth Harbor Marina. It is a brightening, yeah, it's, well, I got it in a box jar. I have another oil around here I want to start using, but I wanted to get through, you know, I don't want to jump back and forth to through a skincare. So I'm going to add just 2-3 drops, because you don't need that much oil. You really don't need that much oil. So we moved home, got homeschooling back up, and that's been interesting. Getting everything moved home was interesting. And now that we're moved home and, you know, I don't have to worry about being at a dealership anywhere all day, every day, then I actually have time to do this again. So I'm looking forward to, you know, being silly, being myself, talking about whatever the heck I want while either playing with makeup or just sitting and gabbing. Who knows? After the oil has had some time to sit, you know, some people say wait 10 minutes, other people just wait until it's, you know, been good and absorbed. And as you can see, I'd say it's pretty absorbed. I'm getting wrinkles. I'm also going to put this Tula Skincare Cooling and Eye Brightening Eye Balm on. I like how it feels, and my eyes have been really, really hurting lately. Just the skin around it, because I haven't been, without having to get up and go to the dealership every day, there's no reason for me to get up and put makeup on every day. So after that, I am going to go in with some Sunday Riley CEO. This is a vitamin C hydrating cream moisturizer. And this is really thick. So I only really use it, you know, like at night or in the afternoon when I don't have anywhere to go. So I'm going to grab a touch. I need more than that, because I've been also trying really hard to put more effort into making sure I put lotion and everything, you know, on my neck and this area, because I am 35. I did not avoid the sun as a child. So I do have skin damage, sun damage from that. And I'm trying to, you know, take a little bit more time to actually look old. I'm pretty sure I'm failing. So you don't need like an extra special lotion or oils. Just put whatever you put on your face right here too, because that is also, depending on the shirts you wear. Most of the time I wear like lower shirts. That sees the sun, that sees the light of day. So, you know, it needs it, right? Oh, that feels good. I have a whole bunch of other skincare on here, which I'm not going to use right now, because that's all I need until I'm going to do another mask before bedtime, because I can and I like to. I don't usually do 2 masks a day or even a mask a day. It's just fun because Ozzy is driving a truck right now to go pick up some stuff, and You know what? He's not here to bug me about hating my skincare. My hands are really dry. So I'm going to use this Humankind Body Souffle stuffs. And I love it. It's smells great. And it's taken me forever to get through that because I'm very bad at keeping my arms and hands and appendages, you know, moisturized. So I have a bunch of other skincare on here, which I like. It's just I use it for different reasons. And your skincare routine should not look like mine. Everybody's skincare routine is different. But the common consensus among dermatologists, especially my dermatologist who I've talked to about it, is you put your skincare on by lightest to thickest, which is why I waited until that very end to put the moisturizer on. I put the oil on before that because, you know, that's the runniest one. But if I put that on before I put the serums on, then it's not going to have any way to get absorbed. Yeah, there's the whole thing. So about once a week, I really should do it more. I have a derma roller. That's the roller with the little needles on it. And you go up and down, side to side, diagonal, back and forth, not hard. I mean, you should not be feeling pain when you use this thing. If you're feeling pain when you use this thing, either your skin is extra, extra sensitive, don't use it, or you're using it wrong. Another thing a lot of people don't use with this is they don't sanitize it. They don't disinfect it. So I actually have 90%, I believe it's 90%. Yeah, 91% rubbing alcohol that I soak this in for 10 minutes before I use it. Because, yeah, it's my skin and I'm the only one that uses it, but, you know, who knows what's living on here right now. So I will use that before I use any, like, serums about once a week because my skin is sensitive. I can't do it every day. And I have a whole bunch of other things. So, but my dinner is cooked, so I'll be right back. And I'm back. Yeah, that was quick. Rice for dinner, because sometimes I just like rice for dinner because I'm weird. Anyway, so let's just start at one end of my desk and move this way. So yes, I have my Too Faced, Good in Bed, Hangover RX, Hyaluronic Acid that I use. I also have these Florence by Mills eye masks. They are little whales, because I guess she has a thing for whales. They are really saturated in serum, so I don't use them too much because it'll be dripping down my face. One thing that I have that I'm going to have to buy more of, but a different brand. And if you guys have any suggestions about what kind I should get, this is the Kula Classic Face Sport Sunscreen Moisturizer with white tea. And it is a good SPF 50, which you should be wearing sunscreen every day, which I'm trying to get better at. I'm trying to get better at. But when I know I'm not going to go outside and face the world, I don't wear it. Because if I wear that stuff in particular, it makes my skin feels just so oily, and all the other skincare that I put underneath it just kind of peels away. So I don't like wearing it unless I have to. another thing I have here is the Avant Biphase Hyaluronic Acid Rejuvenating Micellular Water. This has like an oilish base. You have to shake it up to use it. I like using this to get my eye makeup removed because a lot of the makeup I've been using nowadays, especially the mascara, is waterproof, and that gets it off really good. There's another one that I like better. It's the cleansing oil from, oh, I forget. It's truffle cleansing oil. I always forget what it is. Whenever I get it again, I'll show you. But that stuff is a great oil balm cleansing oil. And it's great if you're going to especially double cleanse and get the makeup off that way. I have what's left of my Curology trial. This has it has a bunch of stuff in it. I don't feel like trying to pronounce these things right now. And I use this when I remember before bed. It is really thick. I also have this Tarte micellular water. It's not Tarte in here though, what is in here is actually Garnier micellar water. This is the one I have in there now, vitamin C, because I feel like I'm lacking in that right now. But I love the pump on this, so I put it in here and cheat. You saw the toner that I use. That one, the tea tree oil one. At night, I also got this, which is the Glow Recipe Avocado Melt Retinol Sleeping Mask. There are really like 2-3 ways you can use this. You can use it as a mask, put it on really thick, and leave it on for like 5-10 minutes and then wash it off. You can use it as a sleeping mask and put on a thicker layer, but not to where you're going to be, you know, able to stick things to your face, and wash it off in the morning. Or you can use it as like a nighttime moisturizer, because how thick it is, you just don't put on as much and then wash your face in the morning as usual. It's depends on how intense you want to use it. It does have retinol, so if you use anything with retinol, you have to wear sunscreen, because retinol makes your skin a lot more sensitive to the sun. Now you know. I also have another Tula. This one is the Rose Glow and Get It Cooling and Brightening Balm. And this one is the Glow and Get It Cooling and Brightening Eye Balm. So they're both pretty much the same thing, but I like them. I also at night use the Elemis Pro Collagen Eye Revive Mask. So this you put on at night, you put a thin layer onto eye contour, leave overnight to absorb, or layer under and over makeup. Use a minimum of 3 times a week, and I try to remember to use it almost every night. But this is a really thick, let me see if I can get off the lid, because I don't have nails, I bit them all off. Tweezers to the rescue. So this is a really thick consistency, so you really don't use that much and it lasts a long time. I'm still trying to work through what's ever on the lid. So after that I have my oil, and I have my little gym bag necessities for whenever I do go to the gym. I have this Peter Thomas Roth Potency Bright and Plump Moisturizer. So this is a vitamin C moisturizer. It smells weird, so I don't use it all that often. And I also have this little travel size of the Glam Glow Glow Starter. I love, love, love this moisturizer, but I'm trying to use all the rest of my collection, which will be a whole nother video of my unopened skincare. I also have the Tarte Drink of H2O. It is the hydrating gel. It is a booster. A good dupe for this is the Neutrogena gel booster. I also have the Volition Snow Mushroom Water Serum, which feels great, smells great, but I'm trying to get through all my other serums and stuff, because I also have the Volition Celery Green Cream Moisturizer. So I'm not using this until I have serums empty enough to use this, because I want to use them together. I have a little sample size of the April Skin Carrot Serum. It actually does feel really good. This is mostly for clearing blemishes, which thankfully, knock on wood, I don't really get. I get a few big blackheads every once in a while, and once in a while when I'm really stressed I get a few pimples down here, but I don't really have acne. Lucky me. This I have, it's a heptapeptide. It is supposed to help with dark circles, aging, all that. It is from the Inky List, which is a really affordable brand from Sephora. I'm talking like I got this for 14 bucks. And I haven't found a skincare setup that it works with yet, because when I use that with any of the other stuff that I have, my skincare, it pills. So that's whenever it doesn't have a good chance to actually, you know, soak into the skin and you can actually rub off all the excess. And this is something I need to buy more of, because it is the best moisturizer I've ever used for my hands and any really cracked areas. I get really cracked knuckles. Don't know why, just do. I don't go around punching things. But this is the First Aid Beauty Ultra Repair Cream. This was a Christmas special. It's vanilla cookie, but it is the only thing that can make my hands actually feel like soft and get rid of the really dry knuckles I have right here without my hands just feeling like I dumped them in oil. So that is what I'm using right now. Well, okay, you know what I'm using right now, but that's what I have open on my desk to go through before I start using anything else. So if you guys have any questions, leave it down in the comment box. I'd really appreciate if you guys liked this video and subscribed, if not shared. And I'm going to try to do my hair stuff on here and show more makeup. I think my next video is going to be me going through my unopened skincare stuff because apparently I'm a hoarder, according to Ozzy. So I hope you guys have a great day and come back to the madness later. Bye, guys.